Greetings, this is Dominic from Dragon Strike Studios with my first instructional video. This one's going to be gear. We're starting right at the bottom, dead basics. We're going to be going over what gear you need to produce reasonably good models. Paintbrushes we're going to be going over, modeling tools, paints, and other little things that you might need to produce a good product. I'll be breaking it up into two categories. First category is requirements, the things you really have to have to produce a good product. The second will be upgrades, things that would be nice to have and make things more convenient when painting and modeling. So I'll be leaving this view and going to a ground level view so I can show you what I'm talking about. See you in a bit. Okay, let's get into it then. What you see assembled before you is a collection of tools I use to do my painting and modeling. Most of what you see here has been tested, and I consider them a good product. First, we'll start off with the very basics. You definitely need to get yourself a good spray paint to base the model with. Armory puts out a really good product. They're anywhere from $5, $6, $7 a can. Does a really excellent job. Puts a good coat on it, doesn't cover up the detail, easy to paint over. They come in white, gray, and black. I also use Army Painters, which is a lot more expensive. You're talking anywhere from $11 to $13, $14 a can, but they are color specific. They put a excellent base coat on a model. I mean, like, you could almost get away with not having to paint the model any base coat color because it's already done for you. So depending on what you're doing, they do have also a large variety of colors. A lot of them are keyed towards GW painting. So if you are a Games Workshop player, you will see a lot of familiar colors, such as like a Space Wolf color, corn color, but gray, white, and black will work fine. If I had to pick one amongst them, I would probably start with either gray or black for just one spray paint. So that is definitely a necessity. So let's put those to the side. Next, I would say you definitely need to have, obviously, your paints. This is a Vallejo color. It is in an eyedropper bottle. Very good product. A lot of people use that. My biggest preference is I love Formula P3 paints. It's a liquid-based pigment, and it shakes up easy. The colors don't separate really, you know, very much, and you get a really good coat, smooth coat. I really like their paints. Citadel puts out, Games Workshop puts out an excellent product too. They're maybe a little more expensive than the other brands, but yeah, you could easily spend hundreds and hundreds of dollars on paints. So, but I do recommend whatever you're painting, buy the paint line for that model. In other words, if you're doing, say, corn and or like Kador, obviously you got to have your different reds and whatever highlights you're going to do. So start off with some good paints. Don't buy like cheap Apple Barrel or, you know, any of that stuff you find in the craft stores for painting ceramics. It just does not do a good job. So I highly recommend you stick with Game Company paints. They do a much better job. This is an ink. These two here, I do recommend you pick up, whether it's P3 or GW or whatever, but you want like a flesh wash and an armor wash. those two are kind of mandatory to get good results. When we do a painting demo, you'll see it is a necessity. Brings me to the brushes. This is a set from Games Workshop, the Citadel ones. And you see there's a variety of brushes here. You have large dry brush, heavy basing brushes, stippling brushes, smaller dry brushes, high detail brushes. They are sable hair brushes, which are some of the best brushes you can buy. They don't have to be game brushes per se, but I find that the game companies put out a variety of brushes best suited for painting miniatures. This set here, this is a set put out by Army Painter. It is a nylon brush, but I find that it does a wonderful job too, and it's a lot cheaper than the sable hair brushes. For anywhere from, I don't know, I think $10 to $15, you can have this set of three, and it comes with a small dry brush, a standard brush, and a high detail brush. And this set alone, if you're going to start somewhere, you may want to start here. It'll give you a good variety of brushes to do what you need to do. I do recommend you pick up a pin vise. What a pin vise is, it's just a small hand drill with this is a 1 millimeter bit. When you buy, Army Painter puts out a, I believe it's Army Painter or P3, puts out a pinning set. And all this is a piece of brass rod. And you drill a hole in one side of what you're looking to attach, and drill a hole in the socket or whatever of where you're looking to attach it to. And with a small piece of this brass rod and some glue, you have a bond that is going to be really hard to separate. So anytime you're doing models where pieces tend to fall off, and I'm sure you've already had it where you're gaming and the arm falls off, that's the best way to keep it from falling apart. Some other basics you really have to have: a hobby knife, a definite must, and some small files. I would highly recommend some small files. This will allow you to clear any flash, smooth any bumps, mold lines, because that tends to make your model look very amateurish when you have pieces of flash hanging off and big mold lines. So I use that to clear them off. The paint or the toothbrush. You're wondering, why the hell's he got a toothbrush there? Well, I do recommend when you before you paint your models, wash them with a mild detergent like a dish soap, only because there's release agents on some of the company's models that won't allow you to get a good paint. It won't adhere, the paint won't adhere to the model well. So I do recommend you wash your models before you paint them. Obviously, you need something to clip them off the sprues. So a good pair of snips. Obviously, you can pretty much use anything you want, but a small pair is much easier to handle and cuts a little smaller, cleaner line when you detach it. I use to mix my paints, I just use styrofoam egg foam. It's readily available, it's as cheap as it gets. You can use the plastic pre-made ones, but I stay away from them because I don't like cleaning them. This I can just throw away when it's dirty, and I've got dozens of egg foam pieces to take its place. So you definitely need something to mix your paints in. So that's a good cheap idea. Obviously, you need a paper towel or tissue. Do not use the puffs or anything like that with lotion in it because you don't want that on your brushes. So I just use a clean, some clean paper towel. This stuff here is a two-part epoxy. It's called Procreate. It's obviously almost used up, but
what it is you use equal parts of the white and the dark gray, you mix them together, and you get a soft epoxy that hardens on its own in a few hours. And what it allows you to do is fill the gaps in the models, because not always is the does the model go together without having small gaps. So this is what you use to fill your gaps. So you can also use green stuff. A lot of people use green stuff. I prefer the Procreate because it's a good smooth product and it doesn't get lumps in it. But green stuff works just fine. So you can get the knead tight, whatever. But that's another thing you're going to need. Going back to the pin vise, the drill bits seem to break a lot. So I found that I can buy 1 millimeter drill bits from eBay. They come from China, and you get like 10 bits for like a buck or two. So they're real cheap. I bought, five or six packs, so I've got like 50 of them, so I'm not worried about running out of drill bits as I break them. The next, obviously clean water. Definitely recommend you stick with clean water when you're painting. Throw it out after a while, because if you allow the color to get too saturated into your water, it will start to stain your brighter, lighter colors. So after you've done, your say your black, and the water's all, gray looking, throw it out before you start on your other ones and get some fresh water. Glues. I really like Army Painter's glue. Also, Zappa Gap, but I would stay away from the little tubes of crazy glue, the little metal tubes, only because it seems like if you press a little hard, it just like vomits glue for the next, 5 minutes. So, a lot of companies make super glue, but I would definitely pick up a plastic tube, and you should do well for a while. Also, PVA glue. This is tacky glue. You can use Elmer's glue, whatever you really prefer. But this is used to glue flock down to the bases, and that's we'll get to flock here. This is Citadel's. This is static grass, and it's used to help flock bases because a model looks a million percent better when it has a nicely flocked base, rather than just painting the base a flat color with some paint. This is also a mixed here. This is stuff you can buy some really good flocks from the railroad companies, the ones that model railroading, like Woodland Scenics. They make a ton of flocks. It's not real expensive, and lasts you a long, long time. So I try to stay with the brighter, greener colors for my good guys, and for the bad guys, I try to go with more sinister, rocky, dead grass kind of look. But that's all up to you. But you do need some flock. Now, starting with stuff off the board, okay. This is a micron pen. It is, you can see it's really tiny. I use the 0.005, which is a really tiny head. It's black. And what it's really good for is eyeballs and doing any writing, say like on a little banner or something, or doing designs. There's much more control with this than there is with a brush. So I use this for tiny words, like on your purity seals and stuff like that. Not a necessity, but very, very handy. When you use the Procreate, now you don't need the tool. You can kind of smooth it out with, just a smooth edge of anything. But I like using, these are dental tools. I can do a lot more with them. You can see there's various pieces or shapes to them, and you can do fur, you can do chainmail, and a lot more with tools. To go along with that, this is a set of silicone tip sculpting tools. Now, you can see they're soft. It's just silicone. And what these are for are shaping and smoothing of the epoxy putty. Now, again, you don't need them. But later on, when you're looking to expand your gear and upgrade a little, these are a good idea if you plan to do any conversions, add stuff to your model, such as like a cloak or something. You definitely want to get into this. Along the same line, these are silicone and steel ball sculpting tools. These are more for ceramics, but I find that the balls work really good for doing certain sculpting techniques, and even the ends are good for bigger models when you're looking to do some conversion work. So these are a little cheaper than the other ones, and you can get them at an AC Moores or any other art supply. So those are when you're getting into the modeling aspect of it. Eyedropper. When you're going to mix paints, almost this should be on the hardboard, because you're able to do drop at a time. And what it allows you to do is mix your paints and mix your waters and stuff like that with a lot more precision. So they're pretty cheap. You can get them on eBay or even probably go to like a drugstore and eyedropper. Pair of tweezers. I recommend that you have a set for the hobby, because you're going to get glue on them, and you really don't want your tweezers for your cosmetics mixing with your hobby. So get yourself a pair. These are vice tweezers, so see they stay together rather than apart. But yeah, for small pieces that you don't want to glue your fingers to, very handy. Dremel obviously is a big investment, but for me, when I'm doing a lot of metal drilling, the pin vise doesn't go into metal as fast as I like, so I use a Dremel to do the metals, and I get a much quicker, easier hole in the model. This is called Instaset. Zip Kicker is another brand. This is Grizzly's, and what it does is it helps instantly set the super glue. So when you have a model that's being stubborn and doesn't seem to want to set, little Zip Kicker, and it pretty much instantly sets the glue in place. But you got to be careful, because it does tend to weaken the bond a bit. So I recommend, if you're going to use the Zip Kicker, that you include a pin to keep it sturdy. Back here, these are some of my personal favorites. This is a line of inks from Liquitex. And they come in a variety of colors. And just like these washes, these inks add an amazing amount of depth to your model. And when I do the painting videos, you will see that the product just like pretty much is indispensable, because the level of detail you can add to a model with the inks is and it's real easy to use. It's really good stuff. I highly recommend it as an upgrade. It's not that cheap. I think one of these bottles goes for around $5 or $6, but it lasts a long time. You don't use a lot of it, but definitely that would be one of my first choices for upgrading later on. This here, I recommend, even though it's not a necessity, it's a paint log. And what it allows you to do is write down the color combinations you use for your models, because I have found that I've gone back and painted some models that I wanted to add to a unit or something, and I don't remember what colors I used. So I keep a log when I do mixes. Like I will say I'm going to mix one part of ink brown ink with, say, one part of green ink, then I'll remember that I mixed one and one and what inks I used. So, and the same thing with paints. So I do recommend you write down if you're doing color mixing or if you just happen to have a tendency to forget what color you chose. A light source, obviously. You don't need anything special, but I do recommend a good light source while you're painting. So a lamp will do fine. Last thing, and you're probably wondering, why is the iPod sitting here? Well, obviously, you don't need an iPod. But I do recommend while you're painting, put some music on. It can be tedious to do a large number of models, say like you are doing, you know, a big unit of, say, 20 or 30 goblins. It can get kind of tedious. So music really helps for me. Whatever music you listen to, that's up to you. But whether it's iPod or just on a radio, whatever, you know. And then I also recommend every once in a while, get up, walk around, go get a drink, come back, because you can get frustrated quickly when you don't think you're getting the progress that you should be getting. So I believe that's everything on the table. As we start doing painting videos, I'll get more in depth on how to use these tools. But here's what you want to start with. It's a good reference to go back to later on. So hope it helped you out. And thanks for watching.